Please remember, Kim Jong-un is a master manipulator.
I have a gift for you.
Oh, this dog is killing me with cuteness.
He's a crazy cute.
From the G7 to the Singapore summit, President Donald Trump has a very busy schedule trying to maybe forge some peace in Korea. I'm here with Peter MacKay, our former foreign affairs minister and current law partner at the Toronto firm Baker McKenzie. You've been behind the scenes. You've been in these bilateral meetings. Tell us what steps it's needed to take to get to this point.
Well, a lot at stake, clearly, and a long history between the United States and North Korea, South Korea. Normally, a summit like this is very prescripted. That is to say, a lot of the communiques would have been written well before the key figures arrive. That's not the case here, although Mike Pompeo, the current Secretary of State in the United States, even before he was affirmed, did in fact travel to North Korea. And so there has been a bit of work done in the run-up to this session. Donald Trump famously said just a few days ago that he will size it up within minutes.
How long will it take to figure out whether or not they're serious? I said, maybe in the first minute. You know, the way they say that you know if you're going to like somebody in the first 5 seconds? You ever hear that one? Well, I think that very quickly I'll know whether or not something good is going to happen.
I have a hard time believing that. I think that there is still a lot of drama, a lot to unfold, and as I said, a lot at stake given what we have seen in the past in these type of exchanges between the United States and North Korea. It has traditionally fallen apart, often at the last minute.
There's a lot of elusiveness about the North Korean leader, Kim Jong-un. He makes his public appearances with these giant military parades and sort of this hero's worship that we see as their propaganda comes out from their news services. But one of the things that has already come out in the Korean media is that this is about denuclearization and getting to that point. So if both of these world leaders, who clearly feel they need to have a win, how do they both go back to their countries and, frankly, for President Trump, go to the world and talk about a win from either side?
Well, that is the hopeful outcome. And keep in mind that the countries that have been most involved in this, the 6+1 talks that have gone on around North Korea for a very long time, have continuously come up short and basically been dormant now for some time. So it is to the president's credit that he has brought it this far, this fast, where we saw Kim Jong-un walking across the border and embracing the president of South Korea. This is into uncharted waters, as is a president sitting down and having a face-to-face discussion. We have heard, as you said, that there appears to be some willingness to put nuclear weapons forward for inspection beyond the ability to deliver them in a missile and to have continued verification of that process. And so now comes the hard part, the heavy lifting. Will they sign on? Will those inspections happen? That's not going to be determined in the next number of days, but if there is full agreement throughout this process on the part of Kim Jong-un, we will have seen tremendous strides forward for a denuclearized peninsula in Korea. And that is a massive service, not only to the South China Sea and the Asian Pacific region, but to the world. And so that is a hopeful outcome. And I think the world is waiting with bated breath.
The world is waiting. The world is watching the Singapore summit. President Trump, we wish you all the best on this very Herculean task. Log on to Facebook and Twitter. Let us know what you think. Will he be successful or not?